Hi there, everyone. Please forgive the mic quality. I have to use the audio recording device that's on iMovie right now because of technical difficulties. Let's just dive right in. LGBTQIA rights have come a long way in a short period of time. Things are so much better and safer now than even when I was young in the 90s, and that's absolutely amazing. However, things being better and issues being solved are two very different things. Even though we have LGBTQIA marriage rights now, there are still many laws in place that make life difficult for us, so we need our community to be at our side so we can support each other through the hard times. Unfortunately, that's not always the way it goes. There's a big issue within and outside the LGBTQIA community that very few people are talking about, and it's causing a lot of strife. You may hear about it in passing, but I've not seen very many people delve really deep into this topic. So, what is the topic? Well, it's the double standard of being non-binary. Before we get too much further in, I want to explain that I'm using the term non-binary as a blanket term for anyone who identifies as anything other than their assigned gender, apart from transgender people. This includes, but is not limited to, genderqueer, genderfluid, drag kings, etc. It's just easier to say non-binary. It's hard to discuss anything LGBTQIA on YouTube, especially when it pertains to people living outside typical gender norms. Part of that is because gender norms tend to change up like every century or so. What was normal in, say, the 1700s, with men wearing wigs that touched their ceilings, more makeup than a clown, and ornate jewelry and clothing, is kind of absurd by today's standards, and I'm sure that they'd have thought we were very boring with what we wear now. The idea of non-binary people and their identities has become very vague and confusing for people trying to follow it, and that tends to cause a lot of frustration in and outside our community. Unfortunately, there doesn't really seem to be a set definition for anyone who identifies as non-binary, and as a result, there's a lot of issues between trans, cis, and non-binary people alike, with some trans people saying that non-binary people are not welcome within their community since they don't get any type of surgery, and since they don't tend to suffer from gender dysphoria, and other transgender people saying, ah, live and let live, it's not really a big deal. If we want people to love and accept us, we need to accept them. And this is the kind of issue that causes confusion. If you've got half of a community saying, no, absolutely not, this is not okay, and we won't stand for it, and the other half of a community saying, why is it such a big deal? Just relax. How are we supposed to know whose words to follow? How are people outside the community to know who they're supposed to follow? Who's telling them the truth? Who they can understand the best? It makes it very difficult for everybody involved then. So what does this have to do with the double standard? Well, unfortunately, these days all of our information more or less comes from the internet, and the more influence someone has over other people, the more likely people are to take their word for whatever the issue is. So when you have certain LGBTQIA people on a platform, such as this one, good old YouTube, who have hundreds of thousands of people following them and hanging on their every word, saying, well, this person is or isn't this or that, and deciding their identity for them, their followers are typically going to go ahead and say, ah, yes, this is what's correct now. And these people, even people within our community, the people who are supposed to be helping people who are our allies, who are outside the community, understand us better, even they are conforming to this double standard. So, in order to help you understand exactly what I'm talking about, I'm going to be using some real-world examples. I'm going to be using a couple of big influencers for one side of the argument, and then myself and my best friend for the other side. So, let's start with two easy ones. Whether you enjoy them, support them, or watch them or not, everyone knows who Jeffree Star and James Charles are. In fact, you could probably identify them on sight if they were walking past you on the street. James Charles has made a living off of wearing makeup. I mean, that's what he became famous for, that whole yearbook fiasco where apparently he'd gotten in trouble for trying to wear makeup in his yearbook photo because he was a boy. That's just it right there. Because he was a boy. That's where the problem lies. Well, it's good for him anyway. When you look under any of James Charles' makeup videos or anything that he posts on Instagram, What do you see? His followers all using he, him pronouns, because regardless of the fact that James Charles does his hair nicely when he goes out, he has gorgeous makeup, more makeup than most models wear, and generally a pair of very nice heels on, people know this is a male. This is a boy who identifies as a boy, and therefore we're going to call him a boy. And not that many people tend to argue that point. They're like, no, James Charles is a guy. That's it. And then you've got the same thing going with Jeffree Star. Jeffree Star arguably presents 100% as female, from the gorgeous flowing wigs to the makeup to the dresses he wears and the heels. Everything says girl, apart from the fact that he clearly has a male body, and it does shine through in some of his photo shoots. But still, even though Jeffree Star completely presents as a woman, people still tend to say he, him when referring to him, because everybody knows Jeffree, again, is a boy, and it's just generally accepted. Now, I'm not going to be completely unfair. Obviously, there are always some people who are going to argue it, some people who aren't going to accept it, especially like homophobic people who are just there to start a fight. I'm not going to say a blanket term of everyone accepts it, but for the most part, especially with the people who actively watch their content, you do see people referring to them as men, regardless of how female they present. And this kind of acceptance doesn't end with them. Look at just about any of the men on YouTube and Instagram especially, who are known to be makeup artists these days, who are known to wear somewhat feminine clothing when they do meet and greets. They're still referred to as men. But this is where the big problem lies. So if a man presents somewhat feminine, whether it's in his jewelry, whether it's in his makeup, his hair, whatever, he is still a man. What happens if someone who's biologically female does the same thing? Well, I'll tell you from my own life experience, not great stuff happens. I could use more famous people for this side of the argument, but since I've actually experienced it firsthand, I feel like it's easier for me to draw from my own life experiences to explain to you what this does. So, not everyone who watches my content may know this, but I actually don't identify as female, and I haven't for a very, very long time. I'm not going to sit here and act like I've known since I was 3 or anything, but I have been out about it to pretty much everyone who knows me since at least 2011, so it's been quite a long time that people have known. Likewise, my best friend is also biologically female, but does not identify as a female, and very recently came out about it only about a month ago. For the most part, everyone seemed to be very accepting of this, until a certain point. Last year, I made a video on my YouTube account, which is now deleted. You can't find it anymore, sorry. And in it, I was talking about how hurtful it is when people dead name me. I was born with an extremely female-sounding name. I've actually always been uncomfortable with it. That is one part of my identity that has never changed, really. I've always felt just kind of wrong when people either said the name I was born with or any of the very feminine nicknames that it comes along with. I didn't like it. It felt weird. I never wanted to say my own name when I was introducing myself. I always made somebody else say it because it just felt incorrect somehow. And at this point, when I was filming this video, I had not planned on making a video that day. I love makeup. I've always loved makeup. It's just something that makes me happy. I'm a goth. We all wear makeup for the most part. And I think it's a really fun form of self-expression, and that anyone should be able to wear makeup if they want to wear makeup. It's fun. It tells people a lot about you when they look you in the face and they see what colors you're using, what styles you're using. It's just fun. And I had been practicing glam makeup that day because I was considering getting some kind of certification, and I wanted to make sure that I felt I was good enough before trying to sign up for a school. So right after I'd done this full smoky eye, eyebrows, beat face, gorgeous makeup, I'd gotten some texts and I got pretty upset. It seemed that a cousin or somebody, I can't remember now, it was a year ago, someone in my life though that I'm close to, had just switched to a different cute nickname, and everyone was chill with that. And in the same breath as them being all like, oh, it's so cute, let's call them whatever the cute nickname was, they were also dead naming me, and I was like, hey, if you're willing to just up and start calling this person by this cute nickname because it's artistic and they like it, why the hell can't you call me by my correct name? And the excuse was, oh, because we haven't had enough time to adjust to it yet. They've known since 2011. They've had plenty of time. So I was upset. I wasn't thinking about the fact that I had a bunch of makeup on my face. I just needed to vent some of my frustration out. And I was quite upset in the video. And unfortunately, the main reason the video is not available on my channel anymore is because of what happened in the comments. While I did have some people who were being very kind to me, I had an equal amount of people being really nasty and stating that because in that video I looked like a girl, I was faking it, that I was the reason people don't respect transgender people, apparently, that I am one of these little Tumblr gender people and stuff, and I just got done with it. I was like, I already felt bad enough over the dead naming, and now I just tried to vent it out on my channel, and I have all these people attacking me and saying because I'm wearing makeup that day, I am a girl. Like, that's it. End of story. Shut up. You're a liar. You're not allowed to even use the word dead naming because you're a girl, because you look like a girl. And my best friend has experienced the exact same thing. My best friend is going as far as to even get top surgery done. That means, yes, there is some gender dysphoria. And for the most part, like, it's kind of a 50-50 mix, depending on the day. Sometimes he looks fully like a boy, and sometimes he likes to wear some eyeliner or a lip color or something because he's a punk rock kind of person. And again, going out, wearing the punk rock makeup, if somebody says the wrong pronoun and he tries to correct them, it's, well, you're wearing makeup, so you're a girl, shut the fuck up, basically. You don't get to say what you are, I get to say what you are. It's so frustrating. Like, and this, it hasn't just happened to us. This happens to pretty much anyone who seems like they're biologically female and wears makeup or has nice hair. Just automatically, you're a girl no matter what you try to say to me, and that's it. But again, you've got like Manny MUA, Jeffree Star, James Charles. They still get to be referred to as boys. They still get to be referred to as whatever gender they identify as. And nobody cares that they're wearing makeup. What is this? This makes absolutely no sense. I shouldn't have to go out and get a bunch of expensive and painful and terrifying surgeries to prove my gender to people that I don't even know. There's a reason I've never wanted to get any kind of top or bottom surgery. It's because I've been through a shitload of surgeries in my life already. They're not a fun time. I'm kind of over it. And my most recent surgery, only about a year and a half ago to this day, had a bunch of complications happen. It was awful. I basically almost died before I got it. Why in the world would I want to put myself through that again intentionally? And that's the issue here. James Charles can say, I identify as a boy, I just want to wear makeup and look pretty and wear heels and stuff, and people are fine with it, and people don't expect him to get surgery or anything. But then you've got someone doing the same thing on the opposite end of the spectrum, and it's a big problem. Why in the world is it that even amongst other trans people, there's this issue of, but if you're biologically a girl, even if you identify as a boy, if you wear makeup, you're a girl, shut the hell up, you're making us look bad, but they have no problem with the guys doing the same thing. I don't even hear that much about people who are trans women. They're more of a masculine lesbian or something. I don't even hear people really barking about that much. It's only people who are like trans men who want to wear makeup. Have you never heard of a drag queen? Why is this a big deal? I think acceptance begins within the community that you're currently in. If you want people outside your community to love and accept you and be kind to you, you need to show that to the people in your own community. And I know that just like my dead naming video, the comments are going to be on fire under this video. I know a lot of people are going to get really upset about what I have to say, but I really don't care at this point. I am so sick and tired of people within my own community trying to stomp me down, sometimes even publicly, and try to claim that I'm lying without even asking me first. Just ask a question, please. Stop assuming things of somebody else. If you, a trans person, want people to be kind and to use your correct pronouns, do the same courtesy for other people in the community. That is all I've got to say right now. As always, do something that makes you happy today, no matter what anyone else thinks about it, and I'll see you all soon.